Hello everyone, this is CS Divesh Goyal. This is part 3, our series of video on annual compliances for the companies. In our earlier videos, we have discussed mandatory annual compliances for our private limited companies and mandatory annual compliances for the public limited companies. In this video, we shall discuss about annual compliances, mandatory annual compliances for a small company. As we know, small company, this concept first time introduced under Companies Act 2013. Under Companies Act 1956, there was no concept like a small company. Small companies are type of private limited companies, and definition as you can see on the screen, as per Section 2, Clause 85, small company means a company other than a public company. A public company cannot be a small company. Small company means a company having paid up share capital does not exceed 50 lakh and turnover does not exceed 2 crore. If both the conditions fulfill, then a company shall be considered as a small company. If you cross any one condition, then you will not consider as a small company. Even proviso is also given that if you are having any holding company, a subsidiary company, you cannot be counted as a small company. If you are a Section 8 company, you cannot be considered as a small company. Further, a company or body corporate governed by any special act, that also cannot be considered as a small company. So this is a concept and definition of the small company. Important features about small company: only a private company can be classified as a small company. Public company cannot be a small company. Even a Section 8 cannot be a small company. Now let's discuss one by one the annual compliances, mandatory annual compliances for a small company. Whenever we talk about a mandatory compliances, there are sometimes some working companies, some non-working companies. Whether your companies are working companies or not a working or non-working companies, these are the mandatory compliances which every small company have to conduct during the financial year. As we know, financial year under Companies Act is April to March. That's why we have divided our compliances also for the period April to March. First annual compliance for a small company is receiving of MBP 1 under Section 184, Subsection 1 from the directors. Every director of the company in the first meeting of the board of directors in each financial year shall disclose his interest in entity. Director will give this disclosure to the company every year on or before first meeting. In this disclosure, he will mention about his interest on the other entities as per Section 184, Subsection 1. Compliance number 2, DIR 8. As per Section 164, Subsection 2, read with Section 143, Subsection 3, Clause G, every director of the company in each financial year will submit a disclosure with the company in which he will disclose that he is not disqualified to continue as a director under Section 164. Compliance number 3, half yearly return. As per Section 405, every company have to file this return half yearly in respect of pending payment to the MSME vendor at the end of the half year. For this purpose, company have to check whether you are having any MSME vendor. Second, whether your payment to the MSME vendor is pending more than 45 days at the end of the half year. If you fulfill both the conditions, you have to file this form every half year. For the half year ending 31st March, you have to file this form till 30th April. For the half year ending 30th September, you have to file this form with the ROC till 30th October. Compliance number 4, yearly compliance, that is DPT 3 under Section 73. Companies required to file this form every year till 30th June in respect of return of deposit and particular not considered as deposit. If a company is having any outstanding deposits, loans or advances as on 31st March at the end of the year, then company have to file this form every year till 30th June. These are the 4 mandatory compliances for the first quarter. Second quarter, July to September. As we know, July to September is the period for the director's report, financial statement and AGM. So as the fifth compliance under Section 134, company have to prepare a director report as per Section 134, Rule 8A. According to that, company have to prepare the director report, and for the small companies, company have to prepare address format of the director report. Address format means the director report compliances for the small company is lesser than the director report compliances of the other companies. So for the small companies, you can prefer the smaller version, address version of the director's report. Compliance number 6 and 7. According to Section 101 Redwill Secretariat Standard, every company will issue a notice for the annual general meeting. As per Section 96, company have to hold at least one annual general meeting every year. So a notice for the annual general meeting shall be sent under Section 101. Notice of the AGM shall be sent to all directors, members, auditors, and debenture trustee, if any. Compliance number 8, circulation of the financial statement and other relevant documents. As we have already discussed in compliance number 6 and 7 about circulation of notice of AGM. Along with circulation of notice of AGM, under Section 136, company have to circulate copy of financial statement, director's report, and auditor's report also. Compliance number 9. As per Rule 12A, every director of the company, all the directors of the company have to file their KYC form with ROC on or before 30th September. So 30th September is due date for these compliances. These are the compliances for the quarter 2. Quarter 3, October to December, compliance number 10. As in the quarter 2, we have prepared the financial statement, director's report, annual return, everything. Under quarter 3, compliance number, now section number 137, compliance number 10, every company had to file e-form KOC form with the registrar of company within 30 days of holding of AGM. As we know, mostly companies hold the AGM in the month of September. So due date for the AOC 4 will fall in the October month. Compliance number 12, section 92. Every company have to file the annual return in e-form MGT 7 with ROC within 60 days of end of half year. So according to this return, company have to file MGT 7 with ROC within 60 days of holding of AGM. So AGM mostly hold in the month of September. So this form due date fall in the month of November. These were the compliances for the quarter 3. Now quarter 4, January to March, there is no mandatory filing for the small company for the quarter January to March. Except our 11 compliances, there are 2-3 more compliances like 12 number. Holding of board meeting. As per section 173, that would Secretariat Standard 1, every small company is required to hold at least 2 board meetings in the financial year, and the minimum gap between both the board meetings should be 90 days. Compliance number 13, maintenance of statutory register. Every company have to maintain many type of statutory register like register of director, register of member, register of director shareholding, register of transfer, etc. Compliance number 14. As we know, every company is required, mandatory required to have a statutory auditor. So auditor's term of appointment is a 5-year. So after every 5-year, company have to file e-form ADT 1 with the register of company for appointment of the auditor. So these are the 14 mandatory compliance of a private limited, small private limited company, which a small company cannot avoid. They have to fulfill, comply with all these compliance to maintain a company as a compliant company. Hope you found this video useful. Further, if you found this video useful, please subscribe our channel. And if you are having any query relating to this topic, you can mention the query in the comment box. Further, if you want to subscribe our WhatsApp group for the regular update, you can message us on 81306577788. Thank you so much.